So if you're new to Mac, you may not know about the Mac App Store or may not have used it much yet. You can usually find the Mac App Store in your dock by default. It's got a little symbol here. It looks like an A for app. And you go into it and it's basically just a store where you can buy software, although a lot of software is free. So you can navigate it using the items at the top. The first item is featured and it's going to show new apps, apps that have just recently been updated, apps that are popular, apps that Apple has reviewed and likes. There's also top charts where you can go in and see the top paid, top free, and top grossing apps. The difference between top paid and grossing is that a lot of apps have in-app purchases. So grossing is kind of combining the initial price, if any, with in-app purchases. You can also dig into categories and it shows you the top three in every category. Or you can dig down into the category itself. Notice on the right there's all sorts of special sections like apps for writers, apps for developers, making music. And these will change periodically. You also find charts here for the section that you're in. So the top paid productivity apps are listed here. There's a section for purchased to see which ones you've purchased. And if they're installed currently you can open them up. One thing to know is that when you buy an app in the Mac App Store, you have basically bought a license to use it whether or not you have it installed. So you can uninstall a piece of software and just go to this purchase section and it will say download and you can download it again. So a piece of software that you may only use occasionally you may not want to actually have on your Mac all the time. Simply re-download it and install it the next time that you need it. There's also a section for updates which will check for updates for all of the software including some pieces that aren't actually from the App Store like here, for instance iTunes. And you'll see notes here telling you what has changed. So when you get an update to a piece of software you may want to go to the update section and read about what has changed. Sometimes there's important notes here that help you get around in the new version very quickly. Now when you go and select a piece of software you can read a lot about it. There's a description. There's what's new in the most recent version here as well. You can find information here on the right. If there's any in-app purchases they'll be listed here. And you can find ratings and reviews. Of course reviews are written by regular everyday users like you and me so sometimes the quality of reviews varies. You should read several of them just to get an idea and kind of discard the best ones and the worst ones to get an idea. And then you have the ability to open the software if you have it installed. If it's something you haven't purchased then you'll get the price there and you can then purchase it. And it will use your iTunes account for the purchase. Now why should you purchase from the Mac App Store? Well, there are a couple of reasons. First, there's security. Any developer that has an app in the Mac App Store is part of the Apple Developer Program, so there's accountability. And also Apple has reviewed to some extent the apps that are there. It's not a complete review, but there are certain things that need to be done in order for the app to be accepted in the App Store. And also, of course, if anything were to go wrong with an app, Apple would pull it from the App Store, where that's not true on the web, where an app that is causing trouble can just remain up there. Another advantage to using the Mac App Store is that you can use the app you've purchased on multiple machines. So if you have, say, a MacBook and an iMac, and they're both yours and you're using the same Apple ID on both, you can download the software you purchased on both those machines. No need to purchase two licenses for that piece of software. And one other reason you may want to use the App Store for most of your app purchases is it's just a single payment system. So you're not buying apps from all sorts of different developers, all sorts of different payment systems. You're just using your iTunes account to do it.